So how can we really assess your biological clock? Well, there's one other aspect of your aging that is crucial that affects your fertility, and that's the number of eggs you started out with. Because really, your best eggs are ovulated first, and your best eggs die first, and your worst eggs are the eggs that have lasted longer. And so if we can just know how many eggs you have, how many you're born with, and therefore how many you have at any age, we can give you an idea how fertile you are. Now, certainly at age 40, a greater percentage of your eggs will be abnormal. But if you have a lot of eggs at age 40, you'll probably have enough normal eggs to be able to get pregnant. Because the abnormal eggs just won't help you, but the normal eggs will be able to help you, and you'll be able to get pregnant and have a baby as long as you have a lot of eggs. So that's where this new test called Antral Follicle Count can make an enormous difference. So let me go through this graph again so you'll understand it a little better. You're born with about 2 million eggs, and then you have about 400,000 eggs by the time you're age 18. Your optimal fertility is somewhere in your early 20s, and your fertility gradually goes down, even in your 20s. And there's a dramatic drop in percentage-wise in fertility at age 37. At the same time, there's a dramatic drop in your number of eggs. The average woman becomes infertile at age 41. Now, that doesn't mean everybody will be, but at least 50% of women are infertile by age 41. And then at least 50% of women go through menopause at age 51, and that's about 10 years later. So that's the general life cycle for an average woman. But are you either below average or above average is what you need to know for planning your life. Now, here's just a sample of an ovary, a cartoon of an ovary at any given time. And at any given time, you have these early primordial follicles, and that just represents resting eggs that are doing nothing, and they're safe. But about 30 a day or 1,000 a month leave that primordial stage and start developing. And eventually they lead to an ovulation, and you ovulate one egg every month. Now, what happens as that is developing is that the egg is getting bigger and it's developing a follicle. And then once it's a mature follicle, it can ovulate. Now, this is just a complicated diagram of the various changes in your hormones during your menstrual cycle. Recognize that these hormones, FSH, LH, estrogen, progesterone, only affect that egg that is about to be ovulated. But that egg that's about to be ovulated, if you look at this chart, began its development 85 days ago. So while you're having your current menstrual cycle, the egg you're about to ovulate in your current cycle began its growth and development about 85 days ago. So during your ovulation, you're only releasing an egg that started growing that left its primordial phase 3 months ago. So if that egg isn't ovulated, if you don't ovulate that egg, if it isn't stimulated by the hormone FSH from your pituitary gland, it dies. And in fact, about 30 eggs every day die. One of those eggs that is rescued by the hormone FSH is the egg that's going to be ovulated 14 days later. But recognize, every single day, 30 eggs are entering that stage of being prepared for ovulation, and 30 eggs are dying. This is just a graph that kind of shows you that the eggs begin to grow without any hormonal stimulation 3 months before your ovulation, and then there's this brief window of pituitary secretion of FSH just when you're about to menstruate, and that recruits follicles and eggs, and one of those 30 eggs recruited on that day is going to develop into the egg that you ovulate. Well, why do I mention all this? Because you have so many resting follicles, resting eggs in your ovaries, and the fertility of the egg you ovulate is related to your age, but it's also related to your total number of eggs. And as you age from age 18 to age 28 to age 38, the number of eggs that are left in your ovaries goes down. And we can count the number of eggs in your ovary by doing a simple ultrasound antral follicle count. In other words, when you have a simple ultrasound, the doctors are usually looking for cysts or tumors or fibroids or some kind of gross pathologic problem. But they almost always neglect to look at the tiny little follicles that look like just little holes in your ovaries, very, very, very small follicles. And if they were to count those follicles, and we call that the antral follicle count, if we count those follicles, some women have a very low count, even at the young age of 27 or 28 or 20 or 30, and some women have a very high count. So the green line here just represents the average antral follicle count over a large group of women at different ages. And we know the average antral follicle count is going down. But some women have a high count at any given age, and some have a low count. And that antral follicle count is what tells us how big your ovarian reserve is, and whether you're one of those 28-year-olds that's still fertile, or whether you're one of those 28-year-olds that better start worrying. Now, if we do in vitro fertilization, we all know that the pregnancy rate is related to the number of eggs that are obtained in a stimulation cycle. Now, you could stimulate mildly and get a small number of eggs, but I mean in a standard conventional stimulation cycle, it's very clear that the pregnancy rate is related to the number of eggs. And you can see from this graph, the number of eggs you retrieve in a IVF cycle is related to your antral follicle count. So I'll just show this quick little movie that will give you an idea of just exactly how we can count antral follicles with ultrasound and determine from that just how fertile you are, or that is where you are right now on your biological clock.
This is Michelle's right ovary, and the black circles are the follicles on her ovary.
The antral follicles are fluid-filled areas where eggs can grow and mature. You can't see eggs with the naked eye. So radiology technician Mary Williams will count the number of antral follicles, those black circles.
Like this one, that one, that one.
That number is directly proportional to the total number of eggs that you have left in your ovaries. Well, by putting it into that mathematical curve, we can tell them when they're likely to become infertile, whether it's in 5 years or 10 years or 1 year.
10, 11. 12. I would say she has 12 antral follicles.
That's 12 on the right ovary, now to the left.
And I'll go through and count the antral follicles on this ovary. So 1, 2, 3, 4.
Now, if you look at this table from Dr. Malcolm Faddy's paper in 2003, which was the real landmark paper on this, you can actually count by looking at the count of the antral follicles on the left. And he talks about it being median number of years to last child. What that really boils down to is how many years of fertility you're likely to have left. Now, it's not a guarantee. Some women will be infertile for other reasons when they've got a lot of antral follicles and lose their infertility earlier. But this is the average number of years in which you have a chance of getting pregnant. So this is the antral follicle count per ovary. And you can see that if you have an antral follicle count of 20 per ovary, or 40 antral follicle counts, you probably have 15 more years of fertility left, and you'll probably go through menopause in about 24 years. On the other hand, if you're down to 10 per ovary, let's say you have an antral follicle count of 20, you may only have 4 years of infertility left, and you're likely to go through menopause about 13 years later. Now, once you get down to where you only have 5 antral follicles per ovary, which is a total count of 10, you're very, very unlikely to still be fertile. Now, you may be able to get pregnant with IVF, but you're unlikely to be fertile. And in fact, you're likely to go through menopause in about 7 or 8 years once your count is down that low. So these are just averages. But it shows you some basic guidelines you can go by. So if you're 25 and you have an antral follicle count of 40, don't worry. But if you're 25 and you have an antral follicle count of 10, then you ought to do something, and that's what we're going to tell you about. Now, here is just a picture that of a woman undergoing stimulation for IVF so that we can retrieve multiple eggs. And we're all used to this. All doctors have seen this pretty regularly. And you can see these follicles that are all with mature eggs in them. So maybe we can get 5 to 10 or 15 eggs in a stimulation cycle. But that's not what we're talking about with antral follicles. With antral follicles, we're talking about a resting ovary, where we have these little tiny follicles that are 2 to 5 millimeters in size, and they are exactly proportional to the number of eggs every day that leave the resting pool, and they are therefore definitely proportional to your total egg count. And they're predictive of how good your result will be with IVF, and they're predictive about how many years of infertility, or rather fertility, you have left before you become infertile. Not a guarantee, but it's a very, very good guideline. And here you can see, I'm just showing you a number of views of ultrasounds where we're looking at, normally these little tiny follicles are disregarded. No one pays attention to them. They're not in the reading. But when you do the standard ultrasound, if the radiology tech will just count these little holes, so to speak, it looks like Swiss cheese, then they'll be able to figure for you just where you are in your biologic clock and how worried you should be. I'm just running through a few of them so you get an idea. In summary, there are two things that affect your advancing infertility or your decreasing fertility as you get older. It's all related to your eggs. First is the number of eggs you have, and second is the quality of the eggs. If you have a large number of eggs, you're likelier to have good quality eggs at whatever age. However, there is no question that even with a large number of eggs, your age does have an independent effect on egg quality. So I'm not saying that if you have a high antral follicle count and you're 40 years old, that you should just rest easy and not worry about trying to have children for another 5 years. Now, that would be a real mistake. What I'm saying is, if you're 25 and have an antral follicle count of 10 or even 15, you should do something about it. Or if you're 38 or 40 and have a high antral follicle count, you shouldn't delay childbearing or freezing your eggs, but on the other hand, at least you know you've got a good prognosis.